Hi gorgeous, welcome back to my channel. My name is Aura. Today I'm going to be doing a get ready with me using several of my new favorite things that I cannot stop reaching for. I picked up many things this year since 2024 started. Several hits, several misses, doesn't really matter, but these are the things I have just been loving since I picked up. Starting off with my new primer, Nars. This is the Light Reflecting Hydrating Primer. I mentioned this in one of my previous videos. It's very similar to the Tatcha Liquid Silk. I'm going to be using this today because I'm using more of a matte foundation, and this actually works so much better with more matte foundations. I find with this primer, not only is it quite luminous and hydrating, but it also makes my forehead look a little bit nicer, and I'm always looking for a primer that makes my forehead look pretty. And this primer just seems to have that grip that I'm looking for. It makes my foundations wear really well. I haven't had any problems with longevity, so I feel like this primer is actually almost just as good as my Tatcha Liquid Silk. But like I had mentioned, just a little too luminous in comparison, but it really does make my fine lines look quite a bit less noticeable. And since the Dior Forever Luminizer has launched, I have been using this nonstop, even more so than my Natasha Denona Luminizer. I adore this one. It did give me some trouble underneath the foundation I'm gonna use today when I wore it on its own. Goodness, get that out. However, I did find a way to make it work, and that's with this primer in particular. So when I tried it just with the foundation and not with my Tatcha Liquid Silk, it did kind of crease up quite a bit for me. But when I tried it with the Tatcha Liquid Silk and this Nars primer, it did a lot better. I have mine in the shade 0. I did pick up more than I intended to, but I am gonna go ahead and color correct with my Charlotte Tilbury. I like to color correct. Sometimes I do it before the luminizer, sometimes I do it after. It just kind of depends on the mood that I'm in. And since my eyes are done, I'm not gonna bring it up too high. I'm gonna kind of keep it a little bit lower, but I definitely have some baggage here to cover. For my foundation, I'm using the Tom Ford New Architecture Soft Matte Foundation. This came out, I want to say March or April, and it's $150 for 1 ounce of product. However, that being said, thankfully I'm getting quite a bit of use out of it. I have loved reaching for it. I don't like it more than my Fenty. Now, I have tried both, and I'm telling you right now, the Fenty just wears so much better for me and my dry skin. And the shade match is perfect for both, so I don't really have a problem with the shade match. It's just more of my skin does better with the luminous Fenty Soft Lit. However, I did pay $150 for this bad boy, so I will be using it. But thankfully, I have had a good time using it. Every time I've worn it, I have enjoyed it. Now, it did take me a little bit of a learning curve, especially with primers that I wanted to use and how it would wear without a primer, but once I kind of figured that part out of what works better for my skin, I've been reaching for it quite a bit. I find this performs better on my skin when I prep well ahead of time, at least the night beforehand. I don't do a whole lot of skincare. I'll be honest with you, outside of my tretinoin and a little bit of moisturizer at night to keep my skin from drying out too much, there's not a whole lot I do. I don't do a typical skincare routine. If anything, I just slap on some Aquaphor whenever I feel like I need it and my skin's a little bit drier than I'd like for it to be, and I just keep going. I don't think I need a whole lot of concealing, but I did pick up the Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade 2 Vanilla. I do need to just kind of add a little bit here and there. I don't feel like I need a whole lot. There's just a couple areas. I've really been liking this concealer. I don't really care for the doe foot applicator too much. I think that really needs a lot of work, but I like that it's lightweight on my skin and I still get a medium to full buildable coverage with it. It's been working out really well under my eyes. I haven't been getting a whole lot of creasing under my eyes, which actually makes me very happy because a lot of the concealers that I did try over the last year were causing me a lot of creasing. I've been kind of sticking to my tried and true favorites, the Natasha Denona, the Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate, which is far too expensive. And those have really been my safe zone. So this was a gamble for me, but I like it. And if I need to touch up my eye makeup, I will. This eye look, if it's not up already, will be coming soon. I combined the Pat McGrath Mothership 3 and Mothership 10. One thing that I have absolutely been loving before powder is using my spray. So I have the Nars Light Reflecting Spray. This doesn't last as long as the Charlotte Tilbury, at least over the month that I've been using it. However, I feel like it just is a little more luminous, and I love that. I was asked in one of my previous videos about these powders in particular and the Suku. I've been using my Anna Sui powder quite a bit more. However, this is a water powder and it has a very strong scent. I still prefer my Christian Dior lavender powder for my under eyes. It's quite a bit lighter. I reach for this all the time. It's just lighter. It has a fragrance to it. It's not as strong as the Anna Sui, but I feel like it still gives my under eyes that luminosity and lightweight feeling without causing heaviness and creasing. So I'm gonna pick this one up on a Sonia G brush and do what I usually always do. I'm just gonna powder here. And once I'm finished with my powdering, then I will wipe it away to kind of help that makeup under my eyes reappear. If you're sensitive to fragrance, steer clear, especially near your eyes. I am very sensitive to fragrance. However, this one doesn't bother me, thankfully. Ever since I picked up this Anna Sui powder off of Beautylish, I have not been able to stop using it. I've reached for this more than my Suku Oil Rich Glow powder. This thing, even though the scent is really strong and it kind of gets to me, but not so bad that I get a headache, and I get used to it pretty quickly. It's nostalgic for me because there is definitely a fragrance in here that is familiar to my childhood. I can't quite put my finger on it, but it doesn't bother me too much. And of all three of the powders I mentioned, this one is the strongest. Now, I wish it had no scent to it because then it wouldn't bother me at all. And then everybody could use it. Because this is one of those water powders that I feel like everybody should try. Despite the price, I think this one is quite worth it. I'm only gonna powder my T-zone because there is a liquid blush that I wanna use that I am super hyped about, so I don't wanna put it all over my face just yet. For bronzer, I have absolutely been loving my RMS Beachwalk Betty Bronzer. This is the lightest shade, it's cool tone. It is so good, it's a baked formula. I find this to be the most flattering on my skin tone of all of the bronzers that have launched this year alone. This one has been my favorite to reach for. One, the undertone, two, the formula, and three, the price is great. I think it was like $36. A lot of the other bronzers I've tried this year have been quite a bit more expensive, but this one for the price and the formula and the undertone for my skin tone is perfect. The only caveat to this bronzer is there is coconut in here, so if you are sensitive to coconut, steer clear of this one. If you are not and you're my skin tone or even lighter, this is a fantastic bronzer. I have this newfound obsession with the Huda Blush Filter Liquid Blush. I have mine in the shade Cotton Candy. This thing is just so magical. $21, you get, I think it's 5 ounces of product. Well, you get quite a bit. I can't remember, but I'll put it on the screen somewhere. This has been the easiest liquid blush that I have ever used. I have no problems blending this out whatsoever. It doesn't disturb my makeup underneath. In fact, I've worn it over powder and I've worn it without powder underneath, and it has performed well each time. And when I put powder over the top, it doesn't break up. So this is absolutely fantastic. I wish I had bought at least two more shades, the strawberry cream, and then there's the deep berry that I think would be beautiful for fall. But this has been my go-to blush, even though this is now the third time I've worn it. I've wanted to wear it. I want to wear this blush because it's so easy to use and so flattering. I love this formula. And this little package is the cutest little package. It's so small and lightweight, but it feels nice and comfortable in my hand. And I could throw this in my bag and travel with it. That's my favorite part. This is gonna be so lightweight to travel with. I'm not wearing any powder just yet, and this thing just blended out on its own so well. I love this thing. This was like Stunningly, one of the best surprises of all the blush launches for me this year. And for liquid highlighters, the Surratt liquid highlighter has been my go-to. I am loving this little highlighter. The formula is so smooth and so flattering. It's easy to blend out. So it has a little subtle pinky lavender tone to it. And I just kind of work it into my sponge and then gently place it over the top of my highlight. Sorry, cheekbones. I have been reaching for this highlight so often. It's been the most comfortable for me. Outside of the Lisa Eldridge, I don't have a whole lot of liquid highlights, but this one has been the bee's knees for me. I love this one. And then I'm gonna go in with my Nars spray one more time just to kind of set everything in place before going over with powder products again. Before I use my blush, I'm just gonna contour my nose really quickly. I always contour. I just like the way that my nose looks after I contour. I feel like I kind of have a large nose. Maybe I don't, I'm just being hard on myself. For blush, I'm gonna use my Chantecaille Sunstone blush. I have mine in the shade Energy. It has that highlight kind of like shine to it, but it's not super luminous. It has just the right amount of flattering shine to it. I have liked this one more than a couple other luminous blushes that have launched. The formula is great. Packaging stinks. I don't really care for the packaging, but I love the formula and I like using it over the top of my blush and my highlight. You can wear it on its own. I have worn it on its own. It's still very flattering that way, but I like wearing it over this Huda blush. It doesn't have noticeable sparkles to it. It's more of like a micronized like pearl finish, which I think is absolutely sophisticated. If you're on the fence between this and the Fenty blush that launched, this one price-wise is $50 more, but the finish is a lot prettier, a lot more sophisticated, quite a bit more toned down. You don't have that strong orange shift to it that the Fenty does, so this one is more flattering for me. I just despise the packaging and the price point, but I love the finish. It's a beautiful blush. I'm gonna finish with just a pressed powder. This is the Chanel Le Beige's. I have mine in the shade B10. It's not really a finishing powder that I reach for so much over some of my favorites. This is more of one that I use for touch-ups, but I wanna use it today because I won't really be able to come back on camera later and show you how I use it for a touch-up, but I've been reaching for this nonstop for touch-ups. So this is more of that matte look that I like, especially when my makeup is kind of breaking up and it's a little too oily even for my liking. This thing is soft and subtle. I love it. This is one of my favorite touch-up powders. And I think I forgot to mention, but this packaging is far more sturdy than a couple of the other Chanel packages that I have. Way heavier. Some of those feel super lightweight and cheap. This one is very nice and luxurious feeling. And I kind of want to carve out my cheekbone just a little bit. So I'm going to use my Anna Sui powder and pick it up here on a puff. I'm going to work it in real good on the cap. And I'm going to bring it this way. Let that sit there for just a second. There we go. I'm going to use my Sonia D Smooth Buffer and I'm just going to brush this away, but also kind of buff everything in to make it look a little more seamless. For lipstick, I'm gonna use Hourglass. I have my lip liner in the shade number 1, Expose, and the lipstick, the Soft Matte Unlocked in the shade Foxglove. I love this shade, but I've been loving the Hourglass lipstick and lip liner anyway since I got them. This one I've used with multiple different lipsticks, and it's flattering, it works on my skin tone, and it lasts all day. I'm just gonna line my lips really quickly, best I can. Kind of fill it in a little bit with this because I wanna use it as more of an ombre. Not my finest work, but I don't care. It doesn't matter how much I prep my lips ahead of time and use any type of lip moisturizer, I always get dry lips. And I don't feel like I need anything over it, but I'm so tempted to put the Fenty Glass Bond oil over the top. Oh, I love this oil, but I don't want to. I don't want to. I'm just going to leave it matte the way I like. This is it, my friends. What do we think? I have absolutely been loving everything that I have played with today. It's very hard for me to not want to reach for these on a daily basis. I want to know what you guys have been reaching for nonstop, whether it's new makeup or old makeup, something that's launched this year or previously, it doesn't matter. This is the stuff that kind of launched this year for the most part that I have just been captivated by and haven't been able to stop playing with. Thank you guys for spending your day with me. I truly appreciate you. I appreciate all of your kind comments. Do something for yourself today because you are worth it.